Okay, ran out of time without any warning, so I went ahead and lofted the wing fill. I always call it the wing root bulge. Wing root bulge. I lofted that. Then I went and changed it back to there, but I'm kind of not liking how abrupt that curve is. What I'm gonna do. Anytime, I deleted everything already, or the lines already, so anytime you want to recreate a line, just get curve from objects, duplicate edge. That basically gives you your edge. And I always link parts that touch the fuselage that aren't the wings or the tail together. What I want to do, I'm actually going to make the fillet on these a little larger, see if that does anything. Still don't like that. So next thing I'm gonna try is a straight lock from here to here. Which is not what we wanted. So the next step is I'm thinking we're just pull this in a little. Do this. That looks a little better, but not by much. I actually move this piece here, this line here, part here, back to here. See, there's a panel line there anyway. Let's try that. My part is when you can't see the keyboard trying to type. That actually looks better, so what I'm going to do is save that. Alright, so we have basically a fuselage and a wing bulge here. One thing I always forget to do that you need to do often is to save. Save a lot. Okay. Next thing we're gonna do is that weird little tail. Whenever I start the tail, I always project. Try and project onto here, just everywhere that might be covered by the tail. Project, click the panel line, and then like that. And basically that tells me this is the top of the fuselage, or the top center of the fuselage. This is where I usually decide if I'm going to do a one-piece tail or a two-piece tail. I think I could pull this off with a two-piece tail. I do put right there. Just planning the parts out. Next thing I do, grabbing ellipse, edge to edge, diameter, like it says. Start here. And you just kind of want to copy the top view of the tail. Make sure quad is on, so that way, because you want to split this little guy here right in the center. Grab an arc. Second one in. I have no idea what it's called. Then you just go to the end of the thing. Then do a mirror. And that gives you these two parts. Join them together. Drag them up. That gets it off the fuselage. And project on the fuselage. And there you go. Now, one thing you'll notice that this thing isn't very straight. Even if you try and straighten it, it's still crooked. And I want it perfectly flat. So I'm going to do a quick plane. Just mix flat. Drag that up to about here. And take this piece. And project it onto the plane. And that gives me perfectly flat. And now, drag it to there. That gets us that. Take our two, our section here, join it, loft, now this line here is the seam, where it's gonna, when you unroll it, this is gonna be the edges. Always make sure you, if you drag it back to here, that's where the flat will be. When I do a tail, I always put it on a separate layer from the fuselage. Okay, and you saw where I decided to do the so you take the same projection really quick before you do anything. Right click on layer 1, copy objects to layer. That way you can select that, trim, and that goes away. And that basically tells you to go to here. Okay. Again, drag them up and project on the fuselage. Okay. Now, I'm going to take this, explode it, take that, project onto the tail. See, we got that little line there. Take even better, it's split. So now you just loft there to there. Except we got a problem here. That's why it's split.